Hi, welcome to Finding Peer-Reviewed Articles in Library Databases. Today we're just going to quickly go over how to do searches and how to find what you need. So starting off, the first thing you do is you get your assignment. Often your assignment will be in the form of a question or a phrase. With this one, it's what are the effects of divorce? Your teacher's requiring 3 peer-reviewed articles and to cite your sources in APA style. So what do? Usually, the first thing people do is quickly go to Google and type in the sentence, what are the effects of divorce? But there's a better way. The better way is to go to the library and use the databases. Today, we're going to be looking at Academic Search Complete, which is an EBSCO database, and I'll show you how to find what you need in there. So when you're looking in library databases, you can't really just type in the sentence, what are the effects of divorce? You're not going to get enough search results, and it'll be very frustrating. So first you need to take a second and think and plan out your search. So if you're using the question, what are the effects of divorce, you need to look for the main concepts and subjects. So for our example, we're going to use the word divorce effects. So once you've gone to Academic Search Complete, we'll type in what we're looking for. And just to kind of show you, why we wouldn't use this search, we'll go ahead and just type it in. What are the effects of divorce? When we do our search, we only get 18 results. This is not going to be enough results in order to find the articles you need for your paper. So if we simply change it to just divorce effects, we see that now we get 772 results. But are these actually what we need? Your teacher required peer-reviewed results. So in order to find those, look over on the left-hand side and click on Scholarly Peer-Reviewed. This narrows it down to 571 results. Each one of these is going to take you to a different article. If you'll notice, the first one just has the article listed. But the second one tells you that there's actually a PDF full text. If you want to only have full text available, click on the full text box. If you do this and you find that you don't have enough articles, or if you did a search without limiting the full text and you want to go ahead and use one of those articles, you'll just need to contact a librarian. You can do that with the information that I'll provide at the end of this. Or you can go to MySPC and go into the Interlibrary Loan tab, and then you'll find the links to this. So you would pick journal articles and then fill in the information you found on that website. So that's how you can go ahead and request those. We want to look at the full text though. It's really simple. Just click on the title of your article. It's going to give you information about your article, and in order to look at this article, you just click on PDF full text. This is going to actually bring up your entire article right here where you can read it. Now, on occasion, you might want to print it, so use the little printer that's down here, or there might be one across the top that you can use. And then that will get you your entire article. You can also email it to yourself by using the little email link, or you can save it in a file and create a sign-in and sign in and be able to access it that way. Okay, when you go back and you look at the information that's provided, you're going to notice an abstract. In the abstract, it's going to give you a summary of what you're looking at. You might want to read this before you read the entire article. This article was 11 pages long, so if you don't want to take the time to read the entire article right away at first, you can check out this abstract and see if it's going to talk about what you need. Never cite from the abstract and always read the full article before you use it in your research. You'll also notice that there's search terms applied. These search terms is how the database has classified this article, and we'll talk more about that in a minute, but I just wanted you to notice that there are subject terms right there. Okay, Not only did you need to find your article and read it and use it, you need to cite it. Over on the right-hand side, you'll see that there's a little cite button. If you click on this, it's going to actually pull up how to cite your article. This right here that I've highlighted is actually your citation for APA, so you can copy and paste that. I would always caution you though, make sure you double check this and make sure it's correct. It's your responsibility to make sure that your citations are right. Let's go ahead and look at one other article. Sorry, I'm using my back button to get back to the list. Okay, all of these you'll notice are PDFs. If I go to the third page, you'll notice one says HTML full text. All that means is it's just a different way of them putting it into your database. So you can click over here on the left, HTML full text, and it will actually pull up the full text. Or when you're on this main page, you can just scroll down and it'll actually be listed right here. This will be your full text. If you want to cite it, the same thing, you can just cite it. If you want to print it, use the printer over here, and you can actually change it to APA citation and hit print. When you do that, it's going to give you the box so that you can print it. Okay, right here will be your reference, so that's how you would cite it, and immediate below it will be your article. So that's how you'll access that. Now let's say that I've done my search and things just aren't coming up that I need. How else are you able to find more results? If you don't have enough results, go ahead and stop and think for a minute. Brainstorms other words to search. So if you are searching about teenagers, think of other words that might be used, like adolescents, juvenile, or young adults, and then plug those into the search box and see if that helps you get more results. You might look at those subjects that we talked about earlier that were listed in your results once you go to a page. If that's not working for you, you might look at articles you've already found or your textbooks for more advanced terms. So maybe there's a word that they use in your discipline that's different than what you would use if you were just talking to your friends about it. Check and see if you're using the right kinds of words. Also, look for your sources listed at the end of articles or in your textbooks, and that will help you find more articles to use. If you need help at any time, feel free to contact us. There's our phone number, 806-716-2330, or you can go to our website, www.southplainscollege.edu/library, and on that page you'll find an instant messenger box that you can type in any questions to us, and anytime we're open that will be available and we'll reply. You can also email us at ref@southplainscollege.edu, or you can stop by anytime we're open. So good luck with your research, and let us know if you need help.